Well, hello there. It's a new day. Shiny, bright, sunny day. All right, I'm getting my move on. I'm gonna go find myself a nice cappuccino. And yeah, enjoy some of this sunshine. Hope you're enjoying yours.
Dopo la Siria, adesso la Vecchia.
Sometimes I just like to look around and just walk and move my body. Oh my gosh, not too many people do that. Maybe it's just me. And this is just the street that I'm staying on, and it's so peaceful and just beautiful. Just get off the beaten path, you know? Venice is like a madhouse with all the people rushing. After 2 years of being cooped up, it's almost like people had to wake up. Wow, were you living your life to begin with? It's a crazy thought how many people need an extreme situation to wake them up and recognize that there's a whole lot of living left to be done. So, yeah. Yeah, that's why I ended up here myself, you know. I felt cooped up, and my life is about experience, and I had been a little bit, what's the best way to say it? Feeling stagnant, yeah, you could definitely say that. You know, 3 years ago, when I landed in the hospital, think about that. I don't know. Someone's not happy. So I had to wake up to my own situation. And I think we all have inner conflict. Some people are confronting it, and some people are magnetizing more conflict around them. You know, you attract where you're at. So whatever's going on inside of you will manifest outside of you. True story. Just admiring the architecture behind me. Yeah. You can maintain the peace easier by confronting the conflict and whatever discomfort is within you than trying to ignore it. Because the more you ignore it, it's like the more you suppress it, the more you push it down, the stronger it comes back at you. And if what you avoid comes back at you, like, because it's a resistance, and what you resist, it persists. It seems counterintuitive because we're taught to avoid pain. But when you avoid the pain, you're avoiding the joy, because you have to recognize that life is a paradox and it's all one and the same. It's just the extreme of one other. It's a contrast. And when you're neutral, neither one of them exists because they become one. So I like to say we ride the pendulum of life. You know, I'm really happy, really, really excited. And then I'm so sad, I'm so unhappy. Well, they're both polar opposites. And when you come back to that meeting point, that neutrality, they become one. So those are the sum of its parts, equalizing. When you recognize that, then maybe you can see the joy and the beauty in it all. It's really not that complicated. It's just us humans who make it so. My Airbnb host actually said that this is considered the new strata, the new road, Nuova Strada. And it's really nice because there's a lot of newer shops along it. And again, like I said, it's nice and peaceful over in this area. So if you come to this area, it's like in its own little paradise, as I'll call it, right? Just hear all different voices, you know, all different languages. Because after 2 years, people are realizing, you know, what's important to you? How are you living your life? What's your priorities? Because you're afraid that somebody will take it away from you again. That's understandable. Never live in fear. Fear should not be your motivator. If anything, love should be. Because fear is a low vibration, low energy, and it depletes your energy, your life force, your prana. If you come from a place of love, you'll always win, even if in the moment it seems you won't. But you have to also discern if it's in your head or from your heart. You have to feel it. Feel it in your soul, your body. Every fiber of your being will speak to you. Look at this. Oh, so beauty. So much beauty. All these buildings. It has to speak to every cell of your being. It has to resonate your frequency. It has to align. Because what doesn't align is not meant to be. The mind will trip you up into the woulda, shoulda, coulda, but the body will move you, literally. Think about that. You know, when someone says they feel moved by something, like music is always a good one. Music moves people. It inspires them to move, whether they move to dance or move to get out of the space. Think about that. Everything's vibrating. Everything is energy. Look at this beautiful fruit. Look at all this beautiful food, you know? Fresh and right there, ripe for the pickings. Everything is. What motivates you? What moves you? What inspires you? What makes you get your groove on? Feel it. Feel it in every part of your body. And if something doesn't feel good, notice that and recognize, is it a memory? What is it trying to tell you? Because it's always telling you something. So I'm going to do a little bit of a different walk. I've actually been down this street, so let's go down that street. Let's see. I know it should bring me to the canal, but maybe there's another way to get around toward the bridge, toward the train station. So, oh, look, a Natura Plus bio store. I wonder if they have anything good in there, because sometimes they have good food, like snacky snacks and stuff. I might go check it out. Yeah, why not? Can't hurt. Yeah, try just enter new doors. Get that idea, it's closed. Yeah, I know a lot of people like to go into churches, and I've just found more than anything, even when I was a little girl, you know, I was raised Catholic. I honestly, even I asked a lot of questions as a kid, and Catholicism and all that got me in trouble, you know, the usual. Questioning authority will do that for you. You know, people who think they know better try to tell you you shouldn't ask the questions. You should just listen and believe them without any tapping into your trust in yourself. That's where most distrust comes from in the world, is people were taught to not trust their own instinct, to not trust what you feel and you believe and you think. And when that happens, then you don't know who to trust. Because of the distrust in the world that you experience, that innately, intuitively within you, you know something's off. You can feel it. But then somebody told you, don't trust that. And as adults, we come back to that space of, well, wait a minute. When I had that gut sensation, it was telling me. It was telling me the truth. It was telling me what to think, you know, was real and feel. And so that's where we have lost the trust within. So when you think in terms of, oh, I can't trust people, or this always happens to me, what's your story? The reality is you were taught to distrust your own instinct, to distrust your own being, your body, your soul, the whispers of your spirit, of your heart, you know? Tap back into that. That's what it's about. That's why I am so passionate about embodiment. Feel it to heal it. Because that's where the truth lies. And there are no lies in your body. It's always speaking your truth. My own life lesson, I've always been involved in fitness. My own life lesson has been to trust what I feel, and I do. And how many times I've gone against what I felt and then been like, I felt that. I knew it in my being. I felt it in my stomach, you know, like something was off. This isn't like, oh, I kind of had a sense. No, you had a sense. You just weren't trusting it. And when you learn to trust that sense, that's your spidey sense. That's your truth. Believe your truth. They won't lie to you. It's just this. We overthink. We need to feel. There's no such thing as overfeeling. Most people are numbing everything out anyway. So, work on the senses. The five senses will heighten your awareness, will heighten your feeling, because the five senses are how you take in data, information, nourishment. And what better way to do it than with travel, with exploring new environments? I'm like a chameleon personally. So I like to meld, like get into the culture, become one, you know? I'm kind of formulating my next plan of travel, and I'm just going with the flow, and it feels really good. I'm sure you can't get enough dolce. I'm gonna go in here and see if they have some dolce. Senza glutine. Un giorno. And then a cappuccino.
La pasticceria qua vicino. C'è forni.
Americans know a cappuccino a little bit bigger than this. This is a normal cappuccino, and I forgot. Guarda la crema. Americans know the cappuccino to be a little bit bigger than this. Yeah. This is the perfect cappuccino. Italian style.
Avrebbe per caso una da 5 per il sigaretto.
Not too caffeinated. It's not.
No.
Out of this beautiful pasticceria for my cappuccino, I am moving on, seeing sights. Just random, making it interesting, as I always do. I always love to check out these guys with the gondolas. Can you imagine 100 euro a day, or an hour, I think it is, they're making. I just love, this is my favorite little corner here, this Trattoria alla Palazzina. Probably already seen me show that, but it's all good. Yes, infinite strolls. Just find your way around these beautiful streets of Venice. Oh yeah. And then the mad rush. The closer you get to the train station, and especially these different bridges, these are where you'll find the most tourists. I think it's supposed to rain today. As you can tell, we've gotten some clouds that have swept in, we'll say, Hotel Bellini. Anyway, I was just on the phone with a friend, fashion shoots. You'll see it all, everything, all walks of life. See over there, off to the left of the church, is the train station. So if you ever come into Venice, You have to find your way around. There's another bridge that goes toward the city, because literally Venice is a floating island. You can go service gondola. Oh, those are never get old. Beautiful bridge. Look at the sky, it's so gorgeous today. And then this gorgeous architecture. Like, where did this artistry disappear to? How did we lose this? People want to say we're more advanced in technology. I would say we're quite devolved of what we once were capable of. Or was it even us? You know, there's all sorts of theories around Tartaria, giants, angels and demons, and oh my, you know. Enrico Nering. Look at this. No ticket. It says free entrance. There was a time, and I do love churches, but the energy feels different to me. And they are tuning forks. Like, they're technically, I believe, the technology that's withheld from us is the recalibration of our frequencies, frequent keys, as we'll say. And we're being bombarded, not just environmentally, by our food, by our waters being poisoned, but also consider this technology. Like, when you put earbuds in your ears, I'm going to tell you from my own perspective of coming from technology and IT, something called Tempest, where it protects you. None of this technology is protected. Like, this here, it's amazing what this makes my chest look like. This is not what my chest looks like. Anyway, it looks like it's not the same. So these still radiate from the phone. Just like when you put earbuds, they're even worse though, because what they're doing is they're connecting through your brain and they're affecting your brain, frying your brain. Changing your frequency with microwave technology. And when I worked in the military in IT environments, I worked with a lot of people who had high incidence rates of cancer, issues with fertility, diseases like cancer, you know, because essentially cancer is carcinogenic, which is the change in the molecular structure. It's when you cook it from the inside out. So we are essentially being cooked from the inside out. And you know, you can only do so much. You really need to be aware of how you are keeping yourself in a high vibration, as well as maintaining your health and your wealth, how you're living your life, how you're nourishing your body. You know, we can only do so much, but that doesn't mean you should just throw caution to the wind and say, well, it is what it is, and, you know, be ignorant of it. You have to find balance in all of it. You can go crazy and get upset and go, oh my God, they're doing all this stuff. They're spraying the skies and they're bombarding us with the technology, the laser beams and the rays and the satellites and EMFs, blah, blah, blah. Balance, people. That will make you crazy. See, that's the pendulum swinging life. You know, you're extreme or extreme. When you come back to neutrality, you walk the middle path and you acknowledge that, okay, I'm aware of that. Awareness is the key to unlocking the doors that you're meant to walk through, not to get all caught up in the, which you notice that? When you get stressed, you hold your breath. That's withholding life force. That is the spirit within you. Every morning you wake up, God loves you so much. He breathes that first breath into you is God-given. He loves us so much that our breath is what keeps us alive. And people have forgotten this, that breath is life. Spirito, spirit. Spirit is breath. So every breath you take is you taking in God, essence, pure source. Don't deny yourself that. Don't act like, oh, I'm not worthy. No, because every breath you take is your worthiness. And when you hold your breath, you withhold your worthiness. You withhold God. It's like that is the cutting off from the spirit of life. So in any time they tell you to put something over and to tell you to hold your breath or cut it off, or heart coherence, you know, it takes 6 feet distance between people is what cuts off our heart resonance, that electromagnetic field that connects us as one. So if you feel despair, you feel all these low vibe emotions, it's because you don't feel connected, and that's why. Just some food for thought as I nourish myself in Venice. Never gets old. And by the way, as far as age goes, you are a soul having a human experience. Look how beautiful that is. You're a soul having a human experience, and you get to choose your story. You get to create your life. All those statues on the top, isn't that amazing? Wow. You are the producer, the writer, the script of your life, you know, you are the main attraction. You are the actor. Now the question is, if you really do truly consider yourself the star of your own show, or are you playing extra and just participating in other people's experiences, which we do from time to time, but what's the main story of your life, and are you living it fully and richly? That's the choice we all have, and the crossroads we all meet. Look at this beautiful art, the colors. Color, look how gorgeous that is. Wow. Boy, I'd love to buy that and bring it home. That is absolutely gorgeous, and even more so inside. Wow. Yeah, beautiful afternoon. Yep, I have to go back though, unfortunately, because I just realized I have to be back at 4:30, and my day's been kind of all over the place, as I typically am. When I am here, I just lose track of time, and that's the way life should be. Yeah. More figgies, and they're on sale till $4.50. Here we are. I got my figs. €7 worth. That's about a not quite a kilo and a half. Now I'm going to find myself another Vaporetto ticket for a week. You got to go to the tobacco stores for that, or you can go to the train station. Got to know where to look. It's not that difficult. It's not that challenging. It's just adapting. Well, that was odd. I just paid $65 for this ticket, and last time it was $60. I don't know if the price just went up or what, but that was odd. Things like that happen, apparently. Maybe it's something in the air. I do know the economy. I've been hearing all sorts of gobbledygook, distraction noise out there. But I don't let it distract me from my life and living. Because right here in the here and now, everything is okay. A little windy again. Going back the way I came. It's so pretty back here, too. Look at the angles of these buildings. Isn't that crazy? Like, what it's like inside. Very narrow corners. But check it out. If you're ever in the market looking to move, there's prices. But they're not that cheap at the moment. But I assure you, bubbles are going to burst everywhere soon. That's my suspicion. Oh, you can have a beautiful villa for $22 million. Or $33 million. That looks pretty good for $30.50. Yep. Location, location, location. Remember that. Always. It's always about where can you find yourself. This is a cantina. A lot of times, believe it or not, cantinas, which are usually wine bars, have some of the most amazing foods. And there's a place in Naples. I'm trying to think of the gentleman's name, but where I used to go all the time, had the best meat, for those of you who like carne, meat, beef. Unbelievable, and such an amazing chef. Hoping you're not getting the wind and feedback I'm feeling across my face, but it feels good too. So, that gorgeous sky. Yeah, here we go. I have to go back, get dressed for another cocktail party because it's that time of the day. Oh, look, delicious. Follow the food, right? Follow the smells. This is my favorite thing to do. Look, fungi. You can never beat the fungi. Fungis are fungi. That was a little joke I made with someone one time. I said, you know, you're like a fungus. You grew on me. He thought that was cute. I thought it was too. Ah, beautiful fashion. Locals. The pigeons just coming over. Hello, though. Hello. Hey, Johnny. What are you up to over here today? Get away from me. I'm trying to keep a low profile. Tourists have food. Stay away from me. It's all mine. I imagine. They're all fed well. Yep. Even the pigeons can be picky, right? Per favore non gettare chicche. You get to take these beautiful walks with me. This is like my delight. And I tell you, the video probably doesn't give it justice. Definitely doesn't do it justice. If it makes my chest look like I've got a sunburn on it and all sorts of issues, that's the strangest thing to me. I'm looking at my own self in the video going, my chest doesn't look like that in person. But that's the deception of technology, right? Brushes, oils, acrylics, and watercolors. Ooh, I could be pretty happy in there. Sun, the clouds descended, and it's supposed to rain later. It says 80% chance of rain, but I'll believe it when I see it. If you could just smell what I smell, the garlic, the cooking. Ooh, do you like costumes? For the Carnevale. Special ateliers. They make the special costumes for the carnival. Yep. One has to wonder. Sometimes the mystery is exciting, but what is the real mystery? Everybody's got a story. Mystery. Taking in the beautiful fresh air. Look at that, just the little touches. Buongiorno. Paradiso, perduto, tutti. Paradise lost. Nothing is lost, just our minds. Crazy humans we are, losing our minds, most of us. When it's really all about just being in your body. Feeling it. Embodiment. Life is about living. It's about embodying. Experiencing. Tapping into those five senses. Reinforcing. And igniting. Expanding. your heightened sense, your spidey sense. You know, they say there's five senses. Well, there's a spidey sense too. And it's the combination of all of them. It's what makes up your intuition. Isn't that gorgeous? Look at that. It looks like eyes on top. You know, the way the arches are. Eyes. Vino Vero, right around the corner for me. All right, going back to the room to change. The bird.
In Venice, we have all these metal plaques. For example, we have one marked inside the water theater.
We look like we're gearing up for some rain, for sure. Saw me run so quickly to catch the taxi to access here. This is funny. My girlfriend's so stressed about it, but we're coming. And we'll make it. We call it in the nick of time. Right over here. I thought it was right next to it. This guy is crazy.
Ready for the red carpet.
Bit nicer today because there's the wind and the breeze. You get a little change of scenery.
is God's artwork. As far as I'm concerned, the beauty is above you and below you and all around you. Ciao, ciao. Buona serata. St. Mark's Square.
Thank you.
No after party. Early night. Tonight.